Hello everyone, this is Christy from Graphicious. It's finally here. We have now LUT support on Camtasia for Windows. LUT support is, it means just look up tables. It's a kind of a term used to describe an array or a matrix of numbers, and they provide like a transformation between the color that your video clip was shot with, the color, no transformation on the color, to a transformation of colors or a computation to change the color, the mood, or the hue, or the color grading of your video clips. So this is one of those things that are available usually in professional color grading software like DaVinci Resolve and others, but now it's available in Camtasia, although not with such a very high level of customization. Camtasia from today, which is the last day of June 2021, has brought this an update. It's 2021.0.5. If you haven't checked for update, go to the help menu and check for update, or you can go to the link in the description to download the latest version of Camtasia 2021. LUTs have been in Camtasia since April when the version of 2021 launched, but it was only available on the Mac. Well, today it's also available on Windows. So I would like to just show you how this works. And it doesn't come with many LUTs in built-in. After you update Camtasia, you're just gonna have one LUT. So I'm gonna show you, there's a link here to download the 35 free LUTs from Rocket Stock, which are free. You can download them. They also work in other software, but they work in Camtasia right now. So you can download these for free. The link is in the description so you can play with them. So let's see how LUTs work. So basically you can use these to change the mood of your clip, to bring multiple clips shot in different conditions or different lighting or possible different colors or white balances. You can bring them to the same color grading, some the same mood, but you can also use them to adjust the overall look of the clip to make it look like a bit vintage or kind of an old look, or pump up the colors or the contrast or any other transformations. There are literally thousands of these LUTs you can download online and use them in Camtasia 2021. You can use the cube format. So let's have a look at how these 35 ones work that you can get from Rocket Stock. So I am here in Camtasia 2021 for Windows. I've just upgraded to the latest version. And let me just bring in some video clips. You can see them all here. They are different types of clips. And my project is just a blank project. It doesn't really matter. So I'm just gonna drag these onto my timeline right here. One of them is a different frame rate, not a problem. I'm going to just keep it at this frame rate. So you can see this video clip here. It has kind of a different color. If I go to the next clip here, it's a bit more glowy or faded out and kind of, you know, gray kind of mood. This one is kind of dark. It has a bit of a blue hue in there. And this one is very much, you know, bright and light. So all of these clips are different moods, different color, you know, different look really. And you can tell they came from different sources. But what you can do with the LUTs is adjust the color of these clips overall and create some nice cinematic effects or vintage looks. So let's see how we can do it. Now in Camtasia 2021, to apply a LUT, so I'm just gonna go back to the first clip here. You go to the visual effects and you can see it here. It's called color LUT. You can just drag that onto your clip like so. You can see already it has changed, and on the right side in the properties, you can see the color LUT effect being applied. You can use this new feature in Camtasia 2021 to turn it on and off to see the difference between the, see how it looks with and without this effect on. And also this is the first LUT here that comes with Camtasia 2021. Nothing much to see here. You can change the intensity as well to see how much the effect is gonna affect your clip. But let's put these new ones that I found, these free ones, let's import these in here. So I've already imported them. If you have not imported them, just download them and you can go extract them from the zip file, and you can go here to import LUT file. You can select them one, or you can select all of them, and it's going to add them into your list right here. So you can see now I have a bunch of LUTs here, and it's really cool how you can see the preview as you just hover your mouse over this list. You can see my video clip changes mood, changes the look and the color, and you can just go top to bottom and just choose whichever you like the most. So I kind of like this vintage one. It's called Paladin. It gives it a kind of a sepia look, and it just kind of washes out all the colors. So, I mean, you know, if you can, if you like this one, it's fair enough. So you can just change these, and you can also, if it's too strong for you, you can also turn the intensity a bit lower so that you can see some of the old color coming through. And also what's cool is, let's go now to another clip here. Look, this one is of course different color, like I showed you at the start. I can apply this effect to multiple clips at the same time. So I'm selecting all three of them, dragging that effect on them, and now selecting all four of them, and I can see the LUT here because it's different on three of them and different on the first one. I have no LUT selected here, but I can just drop it down and just go and choose maybe this purplish kind of look, one light, right? So now this effect, look, it's been applied to all of my clips, right? So look, they kind of now look like they belong together. If I was to put these clips onto the screen at the same time, I would probably be able to see the difference even better. So let me just put them all on top of each other like so, and just resize them a little bit. It's not really important how big they are, but you can see now that they look kind of the same. They have the same look in here, you know, the same kind of color on the clips. So what you can do now is you can actually play with them like this. So you can, you know, see maybe this one is a bit dark, right? So I can turn down the LUT here just a little bit. Maybe this one has a little too much, so you can turn it down, and you can just compare your clips like so, and have this faded out. And also, if you know, if you want to play with more LUTs, different ones, you can just cycle through them, and you can see they all kind of look, they kind of make the videos look similar in color. So another thing that you can do is, this also works with proxy videos. So these clips now don't have proxy on them, so I'm gonna just go to my media library and select all of these clips, right click on them, and this is another feature from Camtasia 2021, proxy video, create proxy video. Okay, so my proxy videos have been generated. You can see this orange dot next to them. I can actually now scroll very fast through my timeline, and I can see it, and the LUTs still work, you know. And it's a good thing, because you can keep the intensity though. So even if I change the LUT on all the clips, the intensity is kept like so. So maybe you want to affect a clip different than others, but you can change them all at the same time. And there you have it. So this is how you apply LUTs here. There's not much control here on how to change the color of the effect and kind of affect, you know, change the LUTs themselves. So that, you know, you have to do these in some other software. But, you know, if you can download a bunch of free ones from the internet and you kind of have a collection of the ones you like the most, they will stay here in Camtasia and you can reuse them in your projects. Another thing that also works is, this also works in combination with the other effects. So for example, this clip on the left here, maybe I don't like it because it's a little too dark. I do like to keep the LUT effect on it, but it's too dark, so I would like to adjust something more on it. Well, you can go to the visual effects and drag a color adjustment on your clip like so. Of course, this one by default is very extreme. I don't know why it defaults like this, but you can of course drag it down. You can drag the brightness up and put the saturation back on there. So like so. So you can actually play and create some of your presets with this. So just to see, it's still too bright. So that's kind of, you know, making it lighter, but also keeping the LUT adjustment. Look, if I turn on and off on this color LUT, it actually shows me the difference between them. So this one, for example, desaturated too much. Let's see it like that. So there you go. It's now darker, it's lighter. So it works in combination with all the other color controls. Another cool trick you can do with this in Camtasia is to group all these clips together and adjust the color LUT all together on them on the group itself. So this is a much more convenient way to do it if you have to do a lot of clips together and you don't want to be, forget to select all of them. So look on my timeline here, I have all these clips. I'm selecting all of them, press Ctrl G to group them. So now I have a group of four clips and you can see here there's no effects applied to it yet, but I can drag this color LUT on the group itself and the color LUT is added to the group. So now I can, create or adjust another LUT on top of the existing ones, or I don't know how you could probably apply this because the color LUTs, they take the color and they just transform it. So I'm not sure if this is very, very useful, but it also works if you, for example, need to put a lot of clips together in a group and adjust the color or the brightness or for all of them in one go and then experiment with a lot of LUTs on the group itself. This can also be done, so it's really cool and it's probably a time saving and it helps you stay organized. This is a really great addition to Camtasia and certainly helps to maybe unify your videos and give them a nicer, more polished look, more cinematic look, whatever you wish. So if you just don't care about too many fancy stuff and you have some videos that you've shot on different lighting, outside, inside, all that stuff, this can help bring them together and give you a nice consistent look on your projects, or just give them a nice crazy look or whatever you want to do with the LUTs. So I hope you've enjoyed this tutorial. If you find it useful, click the subscribe and the like button if you haven't subscribed to my channel, and soon I will have a Camtasia challenge. I'm just announcing it right now. Probably a month from now, I will have a Camtasia challenge where I will do a 30-day challenge with Camtasia videos, Camtasia tutorials, tips and tricks, intros, animations, transitions, everything. It's going to be for a full month. I will be publishing these on my channel. So make sure you subscribe to my channel if you want to stay up to date with these. And if you find my tutorials useful, let me know in the comments if you have any questions. And I will see you on the next one.